Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss arc length. Let's go ahead and do an example of finding the arc length. The question says, find the arc length of y equals the natural log of cosine x over the interval 0, comma, pi over 4. Let's work through its solution. The formula for the arc length is pretty easy to remember. It's L equals, and then you integrate and you go from a to b, and then you take the square root of 1 plus the derivative squared. So dy dx, and it's in parentheses and it's squared dx. So in this problem, they give us the interval, which they usually do. So a is equal to 0, and then b would be pi over 4. It's usually given in almost all of these problems. And then we have y. I'm going to go ahead and write it again. Y equals the natural log of cosine x. And so now we have to differentiate it. That's what dy dx means. So dy dx. Now recall that when you have the derivative of the natural log of x, like let's just say it was ln x by itself, and you took the derivative, it would just be 1 over x. But here, it's the natural log of the cosine of x. So that means we have to use the chain rule. So you take the derivative of the outside function is ln x, it'll be 1 over cosine x, leave the inside untouched, and then times the derivative of the inside function. The inside function is cosine, its derivative is negative sine. So basically, you take the derivative of the outside, you evaluate it at the inside, so you leave it alone, so just 1 over cosine x, and then times the derivative of that inside function, which is negative sine. We can clean this up a little bit more. Right over my little blue equal sign there. There we go. dy dx is equal to, oh, this is going to be sine over cosine, right? So negative sine x over cosine x. Good stuff. That's just equal to negative tangent x. So dy dx is equal to negative tangent x. We'll go ahead and write it one more time. Dy dx is equal to negative tan x. Okay, so now we're going to plug everything into L. So I'm going to switch to white here. So we have L equals, and we're going from a to b. So a was 0, and b was pi over 4. And so this is going to be the square root of 1 plus, and then dy dx is down here, it's negative tan x, so negative tan x, and it's squared. So a lot of the problems when you're studying arc length, you're going to find that a lot of the problems are very similar. Like this problem is going to require a trig identity. Other problems require different skills. So this is the 0, this is pi over 4. So when you square negative tan x, the negative is going to go away. So it's the square root of 1 plus, I'm going to write it like this, tan squared x. And then we still have our dx. Now, 1 plus tan squared is an identity. It's actually equal to secant squared. So L is equal to the definite integral from 0 to pi over 4 of the square root of secant squared x dx. Something really delicate happens next that can easily be overlooked. So let me just talk about it. When you take the square root of secant squared, technically you get the absolute value of secant x, okay? Because the square root of x squared is the absolute value of x. However, secant x is positive between 0 and pi over 4, so you can drop the absolute value. So it matters, it just doesn't matter in this particular problem. If we had been in a different interval where secant was negative, then we would have to put a negative sign in front of the secant. This very rarely happens in arc length problems, but it does happen in other areas of calculus. So something to keep in mind. So this is okay because secant x is positive when x is between 0 and pi over 4, because it's really 1 over cosine and cosine is positive. In any case, it doesn't really affect this problem. So here we have secant x dx. Just something to be aware of. This is a formula that you might not remember. Once you derive the formula for the integral of secant, you won't forget it. So I think it's worth learning how to integrate secant. But the formula says it's secant plus tangent. The natural log of secant plus tangent. Totally worth memorizing this formula. So it's absolutely worth memorizing because it comes up so much. And now we plug in the numbers. So as always, you plug in the top number first. So L is equal to the natural log of the absolute value of the secant of pi over 4 plus the tangent of pi over 4 minus the natural log of the absolute value of the secant of 0 plus the tangent of 0. Okay. Now, the secant of pi over 4, so L equals the natural log, cosine of pi over 4, if you just had cosine of pi over 4, it would be square root of 2 over 2. Secant is 1 over cosine, so you flip the result. So it's 2 over root 2. Tangent of pi over 4 is 1, minus natural log of secant of 0 is 1, because secant is 1 over cosine, and cosine of 0 is 1. So secant of 0 is 1. Tangent of 0 is 0. So just some trig function values. This is L equal to the natural log. We can clean this up. This 2 square root of 2, you can rationalize it by multiplying by 1. So multiply by root 2 over root 2. It becomes 2 root 2 over 2. Optional step, but I think it's a good one. Boom. So just some quick rationalizing there. And so you get square root of 2 plus 1. Some people have it memorized, you know, maybe, you know, if you have secant of pi over 4 memorized, that works too. And then here we get minus natural log, absolute value of 1. However, the natural log of 1 is 0. So this is going to be 0. So we just get L equals ln. You can drop the absolute value, right, because everything's positive. And that would be the arc length. Pretty cool. Not a super hard problem, but it still takes some work. And again, this piece here is 0, so it goes away and we end up with this. So the key point with arc length is obviously memorize the formula. And then whenever you have trig functions, like in this example, in an arc length problem, you're probably going to be using identities. Hopefully this video has helped you learn some math. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck and take care.